Thank you, thank you. For my next trick, I will make rubber ducks appear from nowhere. Okay, here we go. Ta-da! Here we go. Look at all these ducks. You're just jealous of the fact that I can make these appear. To have the ducks, I can do it and you can't, and I'm better than you, and it's.
Hey kids, while your parents chase Duckman away, go grab your mum's credit cards, because I have a new album coming out called Feathers and I, and this is one of the songs about it. It's about all the fruit in the world and
Lemon!
Why'd you have Goose Boy? Who's Goose Boy to you?
Goose Boy's many things. He's an enigma. He's silent, he's deadly. He's mercurial. And he means a lot to me.
Is he your sidekick?
He is.
Say it again.
Documentary.
A stressed duck.
Should we stress duck?
Say duck very duckumentary.
Duckumentary!
Thank you. What's your name?
Goose Boy.
Okay, thank you, Goose Boy. Oh, what's your alter ego?
Dylan Brown. I'm 37. Or 5.
You're old.
I'm old.
Pedo.
Not pedo. How am I a pedo?
Signature catchphrases, Goose Boy.
Ruffle my feathers, duck man. Not in that way. Not in a, like, in a, no, not in a, I didn't ruffle anyone's, I didn't want him to ruffle my feathers. That's not what I mean by that. I mean, like, holy quackers, duck man. Look over there. It's like a silly, goosey thing that I say. Not in a serious, like, ruffle me up. That's what I say when I come out. Ruffle my feathers, duck man. And, well, holy quackers, look over there, duck man. It's goosing time. I'm in a goosey mood. A silly goosey mood for a silly goosey day. I'm a silly goosey boy. Things like that.
Alright, so, just watch this. So I can actually summon Goose Boy at any point I want to. So, just, it's really easy. So, alright, here we go. I'm gonna do it now for you. Quack!
What in the feathered fuck is going on, duck man? Well, I get up whenever duck man tells me to be up and ready, and I go out with Duckman as Goose Boy and follow his lead.
I don't go out.
You do, Duckman.
I'm legally not allowed.
Yeah, I know, but you'd still.
Shut up.
Sorry, I go and do stuff that Duckman can't do.
What did you do before this job, Goose Boy?
I was an accountant.
Where did you work? What did that entail?
An accounting firm. Numbers. Accounting is not. And that's it. That's all it was.
And what's your dream in life? What's your dream job?
Well, maybe one day more than a sidekick. Maybe stop picking up after Duckman all the time. Anything like that, really.
Can you tell us about your music career?
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah. So I've got this brand new album coming out called Feathers and Me. And it's all based on sort of, it's like a rock opera sort of thing, all based on Duckman and I. And I tried, Duckman wasn't too pleased when I tried to show him it, but. This is all the fruit in the world, starting with lemons. Lemons are the bad guy of the fruits. Oh, lemon, you are so bitter. When you litter, and your mum, she's so much fitter when she litters. Still makes her bad though. after stopping that lemon, that bitter lemon, from littering feathers and I. Stopping lemons every day.
You get recognised in the community for sure when you work with Duckman. Not always for the best of reasons. I have had good shit thrown at me, but at least it's you get recognised. You get your name out there again. Helps the music being, you know, sidekick to Gooseman. It's
Duckman,
not Gooseman. But I mean, geese are bigger, so I don't understand where that name. I don't understand
that
why.
Geese are bigger. Ducks are bigger.
And what have you ever seen
ducks
a duck?
Are bigger
have you
than
seen
geese.
A duck? Have you seen a goose?
No. Alright, let's get back on track. Okay.
Yeah.
How'd you make the costume?
So these are feathers. Or that was the idea behind it. And I was washing Duckman's laundry once, and it fell on me like this, and I sort of started running around with it, and then I needed obviously a helmet, and this is you know, I sort of found it lying around, and I didn't, the goggles I wasn't a huge fan of, but Duckman saw them and wanted me to wear them all the time. He doesn't really let me take them off. That part of the costume's mandatory, I think, now. But the rest of it I quite like. It makes me look like a goose, a white goose. The hardest part of the job is, you know, trying to keep your reputation up, especially when you're working for somebody that obviously can't leave and you have to do other stuff for them. I love it because, you know, getting my name out there, music. I need the music. It's all about the music, man.
He doesn't help me.
Well, I do.
You just have, like, catchphrases. You don't really do
anything. Well, when you wake up your day every morning to it's goosing time.
I don't want to publicise my suspicions towards my sidekick, but they exist. And I believe that he is in cahoots with a nemesis of mine.
Who's this nemesis?
Squirrel Girl.
Hello? Hello, yeah, I can't hear you. Can you just, hello, yes. Listen, he is useless. He can't do anything. You want him to save the, no. Listen, this is a code red. I can't get him to do a single thing. He's not followed any instructions. I know you said it should be easy. I know what you said. But he won't, no, I know. But he won't do it. He's made my life hell. Code, you're not listening, code red.